The county releasing that late in response to this judge's ruling. And today in court, the lawyers representing these two strip clubs, they argued that if people were allowed to shop in things like shopping malls and grocery stores, then live adult entertainment should also be allowed to continue indoors. But what many did not know is that that ruling would also begin to encompass all of San Diego County's restaurants.
As thousands of businesses across San Diego County struggle to survive, a win in the court for strip clubs could be their unlikely lifeline.
And I think this was a win for those businesses because that's what they wanted to do anyway. They just wanted the same opportunity that other businesses had to, you know, to operate safely.
On Wednesday, a San Diego County Superior Court judge ruled that Pacers and Cheetahs can remain open despite current restrictions. But his ruling goes much further than that. In court documents, the judge questions whether there's a rational nexus or connection between the percentage of ICU bed capacity throughout Southern California and the plaintiff's establishments in San Diego County, continuing that defendants have provided the court with no evidence that plaintiffs providing live adult entertainment and San Diego businesses with restaurant service who've implemented protocols have impacted the Southern California region.
So the county is now going to be suspending any enforcement against restaurants and the adult entertainment establishments.
And now an about face from the county confirming as they analyze their next steps, they have, quote, suspended enforcement activities against restaurants.
It's a victory for business owners. It's a victory for small business owners who were willing to do the right thing. They bought all the equipment. They bought the heaters. They bought the outside equipment. They were doing all the right things, wearing the masks and keeping their customers and their employees safe.
Businesses like Redford's Diner, who tonight reacted to the possibility of what they call a Christmas miracle.
I was extremely happy for my employees. I was thinking that Merry Christmas might be right here.
It's a feeling that many who have been forced to lay off staff right around the holidays share as they reflect on steps they're taking to protect the public.
You know, we've been shut and closed 5 times. We put up the dividers, we wear the masks, we distance. Hey, you know what? Shut indoor dining. Guess what? You guys can open outside. We spent $40,000 doing outdoor dining. Hey, you know what? You can't do that either. Go back to go. Of course, I don't believe that we're responsible for any COVID.
And as the judge stated in his ruling, he agrees that cases are not being traced back to restaurants who are following COVID-19 protocols.
I'm not sure if you've been able to kind of be in on those conversations of the kind of legal counteraction that could potentially be coming, which would add another whiplash to these business owners who are getting their hopes up tonight.
Well, there is an appeal. I'm sure the state will appeal this order. And unfortunately, the county will too. However, those businesses will be allowed to stay open during an appeal. And I don't know, the appeal could take months.
And while this feels like a win, Desmond warns against the potential loss that could come if people let their guard down.
We still have to fight the virus. It is still out there and our numbers are going up. And, our ICU beds are holding at about 85%, which is okay, but we need to get that number down.
So once again, what restrictions exactly will or will not be enforced by the county remains unclear. Will it be things like capacity limits or hours of operation, indoor, outdoor? We are still waiting for those specifics. Now, the state did not respond to immediate requests for comment about this ruling. But as you heard Supervisor Desmond say, the legal battle will likely continue for months in the future. For now, reporting here in Claremont, Hunter Sowards, KUSI News.